Hey all, welcome back once again to my YouTube class. I'm Manjeet Rawat, your online instructor. This is another session of how to become system administrator playlist. In previous class, we discussed about how to establish our additional domain controller. I'm talking about the intra-site replication, because whenever we establish our additional domain controller, which is also a part of intra-site replication. So apart from set up our additional domain controller, we also need to know about the procedure, how we can transfer FSOMO roles from one domain controller to another domain controller. And you also need to know about the concept of each and every FSOMO roles. So let me move ourselves to the screen and let me guide you each and every part related to transferring FSOMO roles from one domain to another domain. And we'll also guide you about the use cases or work of these FSOMO roles. You know that whenever we establish our domain controller, any root domain controller, it will automatically give you five different types of roles, and each and every roles can perform their own task. So let me move myself to the screen. But before that, if you're new on my YouTube channel, if you're watching my video first time, do subscribe, because Teach Me Cloud is a single technical training based YouTube channel that give you 100% live practical based video without skip any step. So let me guide you about the agenda and procedure, and after that we'll show you the practical properly step by step. I hope you guys are able to see my screen. We are trying to understand about the concept of FSOMO roles. As we know that to set up our additional domain controller, in previous class we already completed all the steps that required to establish our additional domain controller. So maybe this is my root domain that I established with name of cloud.com, and you can consider it as a PDC, means primary domain controller. And this one is our ADC that we established in previous class, maybe with name of adc.cloud.com, right? And both machines are connected, definitely connected to each other. And we already replicated all the Active Directory services from our parent domain controller to the additional domain controller. Guys, try to understand about the work of FSOMO role. Five different types of FSOMO roles are available, as we discussed before, which is categorized into different part. One is forest wide, and the another one is domain wide, right? So you can categorize your FSOMO roles in two different part. In forest wide, we are able to find schema master, right? This is one role. Number second is domain naming master. You can also consider it as a naming master, domain naming master. Number third, PDC emulator. And number four, RID pool manager, MGR. And number last, infrastructure. Number five, infrastructure master. So these five different roles you will find whenever we establish our root domain controller. Our responsibility to divide our workload, means these five roles are available in our PDC, by default available on PDC, but our responsibility, we need to know about the procedure how we can transfer these FSOMO roles to the additional domain controller, right? So we have a two different method. Second important part, transfer FSMO roles to ADC, right? We are transferring FSMO role to ADC server or any other domain controller that are available in the environment. We have two different method, guys. One is using CLI. I'm talking about the command line interface. And number second, using graphical user interface. With the help of GUI, we are also able to transfer the FSOMO roles to the another domain controller which are available in that moment. So now I'm going to guide you about the procedure, how to transfer FSOMO role with the help of CLI, and then we'll also discuss about the method of GUI. How we can do that? I have already established my domain controller. So let me open my root domain controller first. So this is my root domain controller or parent domain controller. Open CMD and execute command net dump query FSOMO, right? This is the command that will help you to identify the location of your domain controller. So I think all the domain, all the FSOMO roles are available in same computer. See, WinGK21 something. schema, domain naming, PDC, RID, pool manager, infrastructure master, and like so all the five different roles are available on same location. This one is my additional domain controller. So let me open CMD and execute the same command, net dom query fsmo. And let's see the location of our fsmo role. Same, right? So whenever we execute the command of net dom query on another computer, means additional domain controller, it will also give you the same information that your domain, your fsmo roles are available in the root domain controller. But our responsibility, we need to transfer these roles to the additional domain controller. This one is our additional domain controller, additional ADC-2. This is the name of this machine, and I'm trying to transfer the FSM roles to this computer. So no matter you are on the page of a root domain controller or you are trying to execute the commands from the same machine where you want to capture or transfer the entire FSM roles, so you can execute these commands on any machine, like on root domain controller or additional domain controller. Your command will be applicable to transfer the FSMO role, no matter you are trying to transfer through the root domain controller or from the additional domain controller. Clear? So what are the points that we need to keep in our mind while transferring FSMO role? First command, ntdsutil. This is first command you need to execute. It will redirect you on the page of maintenance page, right? First command is ntds.util, second command roles, and the third command you need to execute connections. Okay, make sure case sensitive and spelling. And after connections, you need to execute command connect to server, and space server name, as we discussed, ADC-2. This is the name of our additional domain controller, and connected to the ADC using credential of locally logged on. Done, we successfully connected. You need to execute the command of quit, and the last final command that you need to execute, transfer space, like I'm going to transfer PDC. Yes, I want you to transfer. Second command, I'm going to transfer naming master. Okay, so I'm talking about domain naming master. So we successfully transferred two different roles from domain controller, root domain controller, to additional domain controller. Let me execute again same command, netdom query space fsmo. Okay, so netdom query space fsmo, and wait for few more seconds and see, two different roles are successfully shifted to the additional domain controller too, and the rest of fsmo roles are available on the same root domain controller. So guys, with the help of transfer command, you can transfer all the FSMO roles which are available on our root domain controller. So let me guide you properly, like, because you know that you want to create a kind of notes. So let me mention all the commands that you need to execute. Transfer FSMO roles using what? Using CLI, right? We are trying to transfer FSMO role with the help of CLI method. So what are the steps required? First command, net dom query space FSMO, right? You need to execute this particular command to identify the location of our entire FSMO roles, and then ntdsutil. This command will redirect us on the page of maintenance, then connections, hit enter, then again need to execute command connect to server, and space server name or IP address of server, hit enter again, then execute command quit, then transfer space name of FSMO role, name of role, right? So by using these commands, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, by using 6 different commands, okay, before that you need to also execute the command of roles, guys. 7 different commands, by using 7 different commands, we are able to transfer our FSMO roles from one server to another server. 5, 6 and 7. Alright guys, we need to discuss more about it, because we also need to know about the procedure, how we can transfer FSMO role with the help of GUI method. So in upcoming class, I'm going to guide you about the step. I'm going to guide you about the procedure, how we can transfer our FSMO roles with the help of GUI, graphical user interface. And we'll also discuss about the C's, because there are two different types of command we need to use. One is transfer and another is C's. So why we need to use transfer, why we need to implement the command of C's, so we are going to discuss in our upcoming class. I hope everyone okay with the point that we discussed today. Please try to implement your practical by self, right? And we'll connect soon in another class. Take care. Bye-bye. Do subscribe your Teach Me Cloud YouTube channel. Bye, guys.